Welcome to this overview video, where we'll take a more in-depth look at Soothe Live by OX Sound. Available on Avid S6L and HDX systems, Soothe Live is a dynamic resonance suppressor that automatically detects resonances and applies suitable reduction. Feel free to use the timestamps to move around in this video. Let's jump right in. The user interface is divided into different sections: the frequency graph, the main section, the band section, the output section, and the sidechain section. On top of the frequency graph, the toolbar shows the currently selected parameter's name, value, and a short tooltip. You can access a quick start guide by clicking on the help icon on the right-hand corner of the toolbar. The quick start guide has basic information on all parameters and some helpful pointers on value ranges. The frequency graph shows each resonance being cut and the amount of reduction Soothe Live is applying. The reduction range in decibels is shown on the right-hand side. The frequency graph also has the sensitivity curve, which you can use to focus the processing in frequency areas of your choosing. The sensitivity curve can be adjusted using the four bell bands, along with the low cut and high cut bands. After selecting a band, you can adjust the frequency, sensitivity, and width using touchscreen gestures or by using the band controls on the left-hand side. The higher the node, the more reduction will be applied to that region, and vice versa. You can have Soothe ignore an area by adjusting the low or high cut bands. All bands can also be adjusted using the knobs on the control surface. To inactivate a frequency band, just double tap or click a node. Next, we'll go over the main section, where you control the general behavior of Soothe Live. Depth controls the general amount of processing. It can be thought of as the main sensitivity or drive. To put it simply, more depth results in bigger cuts. Because Soothe Live is level dependent, always adjust depth according to the input source, even when using presets. Depth itself is not calibrated to any particular threshold. However, at moderate settings, you can compensate for changes in input gain by adjusting the depth with a corresponding amount. For example, if you need to adjust a track's input gain down by 4 decibels, you can achieve the same reduction as earlier by adjusting the depth up by 4. Remember, you can always see the absolute amount of reduction in decibels on the right-hand side of the frequency graph. Detail controls resonance detection and reduction, as well as the dynamic response. At its endpoints, we have broad and fine. Use broad detail for addressing general energy buildups and fine detail for any complex sound sources with sharp, prominent resonances, like drum overheads. The first third of detail results in more level-dependent processing, with Soothe being less selective, cutting almost all resonances. This way, Soothe acts roughly like a multiband compressor. Stuff to lose. I believe I got the juice. Let me be the one you choose, baby. A good overall detail range for vocals and most instruments is from 3 to 7. Detail values 7 to 10 result in increasing level independence, with sharper cuts and more selective resonance detection. Until we see. This means Soothe cuts only the most prominent resonances. Fine detail can also be useful when tackling very specific resonances, such as those found in closed mic string and wind instruments. However, when detail is near its maximum value, it can start sounding artificial, unless the material has extremely sharp resonances. Speed is the attack and release of the processing. It controls how fast Sooth Live reacts to resonances and how fast it recovers when they're no longer detected.
Hold me, and I'm a believer of the truth, cause I believe I got the juice, yeah, I believe I got the juice, baby.
A speed value of 2 to 5 is good for overall transparent processing on vocals and most instruments. In this range, the attack and release are similar in length. If you need to control an aggressive onset, adjust the speed faster. A speed value of 0 to 2 gives you a very fast attack and a fast release. This can be good for dealing with aggressive cymbals or electric guitars. The fast attack range can also be used to the same effect as parallel compression on vocals when blended in using the mix control. Sometimes you want to let the onset through, but still need to take care of the resonances. Using slower speed values achieves this. In the 5 to 8 range, the attack speed is slower than the release speed. This can be used, for example, on slap bass guitar, percussive instruments, plucky synth sounds, or for cutting an overly resonant ride bell from the overhead channel. The speed range from 8 to 10 has an extremely long attack and release. This range is useful for general tonal control in instrument, group, or master channels.
Until we see the sun, one touch that make you something loose. I believe I got the juice.
Don't worry if you don't remember all these parameter ranges. You can always refer to the Quick Start Guide for a summary of the information in this video. In the output section, we have mix, trim, delta, and bypass. Delta is the difference between the wet and the dry signals. Toggle delta on to hear the resonances Sooth Live is removing. This is a useful tool for finding resonances faster during virtual sound checks or in-ear monitor mixing. Note that delta can only be toggled when the SXL is in config mode. When in show mode, the delta will stay in the state last used in config mode. The delta state is saved and recalled with snapshots and presets. Bypass is the plugin's click-free internal bypass. Use it for a before and after comparison.
Until we see the sun, one touch that'll make you something loose. I believe I got the juice. Let me be the one.
The internal bypass does not bypass Sooth Live's processing in the background, so the CPU will still be engaged. To free up CPU resources, the plugin must be removed from the plugin rack's insert slot. The mix control blends the dry signal in with the wet signal. It sometimes sounds better to crank up the depth and then turn down the mix to around 80%. You can also see the maximum reduction range in decibels while the mix parameter is being adjusted. Use trim to make up for any loss in volume Sooth Live might have introduced. Trim is the output compensation gain. By default, trim is set to 1 to compensate for the gain reduction caused by the default preset. The sidechain feature lets you use an external input as the source for SoothLive's resonance detection. Select the channel you want to use as the sidechain input and tap the sidechain icon to activate it. SoothLive's sidechain has many applications. For example, carve out space for the vocals on the music bus. Duck synths and backing tracks using the kick drum.
We'll be like this all night. Hold me, I'm a believer of the truth. Cause I believe I got the truth.
Control hi-hat bleed on the snare channel. Or prioritize the talent's own channel in their monitor mix. That was our overview video of SoothLive. For further information, make sure to check out our website and product manual. Thank you so much for watching.